Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Now, just before we talk a little bit about environment variables, let's go ahead and just record and build a list of installed packages. Building a list of installed packages is really useful, particularly when we want to replicate our project in a different environment. Take, for example, you were to download this project onto your computer and you wanted to then replicate the environment so that you could start the project. How would you know what packages need to be installed? Well, of course, at this point, all we have is Django installed. So you can probably just go ahead and pip install Django and you would know that everything would work okay. But eventually our project is going to require multiple packages. So we are going to need to record what packages are installed. It's also a good way of identifying what versions of those packages that we're using, because there might be some breaking changes on new packages and so on. So it's important to keep a record of what packages we have and what currently works in our environment, so that we can ensure that we can consistently roll out our application and the environment in multiple environments. If that didn't make sense, don't worry. Let's just go ahead and show you how to close everything down. So sometimes it gets a bit messy up here, and you can use this option here just to close everything down. And then don't forget, on Windows, CLS, on a Mac, Control K. Right. So make sure, first of all, that we exit this. Okay. So we exit the Python interpreter there. I typed in exit and then the parentheses. Right. So back in our project then, let's go ahead now and pip free. So first of all, let's just make sure that we're in the right directory. We should be in the directory where we are accessing manage.py. Okay, so if you're not, just cd into the correct folder. Now what we can do is cd into the folder, drf, blah, blah, blah. Or if you want to go back up a folder, up the folder structure into the previous folder, then you can type in dot, dot, dash. And that would then take you back into the main folder here, or the folder that's a level above. So if you want to go back now into this folder here, the DRF folder, because currently we're inside of this folder. So if we want to go back into this folder, we just need to type in CD and DRF and so on. Right. So let's go ahead and use pip freeze. So pip freeze and then the right chevron. And then we just need to name the file that we want to create. So we want to list all the packages that are installed and we want to put it into a nice list. So we can call that requirements.txt. Now, what we might do here in actual fact is, like settings, you can make a pip freeze file for local and for development, because you might have different packages installed in different environments. So we're not going to do that for now. Let's just go ahead and type in requirements.txt. There we go. You can type in whatever you like, call it whatever you like. It doesn't matter. And there we go. We've now made a list of all the packages that are currently installed. And like I said, there isn't too many here at the moment, but eventually there will be many more. Now, you may be wondering what SQL parse is and ASGI ref. Now, these are just packages that Django requires. We may not be using them at this point, of course, but there may be a need for some of those packages in order for Django to work correctly. So we don't need to worry about them and the exacts of them, just the fact that we're running Django. You'll find that Django automatically installs those packages for us. Now, this can get quite messy, and sometimes what can be useful is if you actually just record separately the packages that are installed. So here in this file here, I'm just going to type in packages. So what we've installed so far is Django. And that gives us a better idea of what exactly is installed, because what you will find when you install packages, there may be multiple dependent packages that are installed, and it can get a bit messy and hard to remember exactly what it is that you've actually installed initially. So keeping a record of the actual packages that you're using can be useful. You can use numbers if you like, the actual version numbers, but I'm just going to record it there so we know and can keep track of what actual packages that we're using. So like I said at the start, if you wanted to now replicate this project, let's imagine that you downloaded all this code from GitHub. So you would create your virtual environment, you'd start up the virtual environment, and then you would then take the next step of loading up all the requirements. So instead of now running pip install like we did previously, Django, what we can now do is tell pip to install all the packages from a particular file. So here, so we can say pip install, and then we can use the R flag to tell pip that we're going to install from a list of requirements, and then we can go ahead and run the requirements. And pip will then install all the packages and the versions of those packages that are detailed here in the requirements file.